Dear participants, good afternoon to all of you, and a very welcome from the National Institute of Electronics and Information Technology, Srinagar, Government of India. As it is reflected on the board that my topic is Introduction to Research. Please. Next slide. My presentation is divided into several parts. As it is clearly reflected from the board, what research is, why to undertake research, and what are the divergent opinions on research, characteristics of research, types of research, knowledge, the fountain of research, and at the end there is summary. What research is? There are number of definitions on research, and I have quoted one among them. Research is an endeavor to discover, develop, and verify knowledge. So far as the first aspect of the definition is concerned, research is an attempt to discover knowledge. Discovery of knowledge is one of the important issues in the research process. What discovery means? Simply, discovery consists of seeing what everybody is seeing, but thinking what everybody has not thought. In order to explain it in a broad perspective, let me quote Newton. Everyone knows that before Newton, thousands of people have seen falling apple on earth. But it was Newton who gave the patient thought that why it happened, because of his keen observation. So discovery of knowledge, our research starts from the discovery of knowledge. Discovery of knowledge is the important, and another aspect in the research is the to develop knowledge. Yes, this is the central point in the research process, because knowledge expires, knowledge lost its temporal validity, knowledge obsoletes. Knowledge becomes invalid, and that is why we have to develop knowledge to make knowledge relevant to the contemporary era. I remember when I was introduced to the computer world, I was introduced to the DOS, but DOS is gone now. You have now other operating systems. So developing knowledge is the core in the research process. And similarly, you have the verification of knowledge. Very important aspect, because we are living in the 21st century where knowledge explosion has already taken place. We are bound to know which knowledge is correct, which knowledge is not correct. So we have to keep all these aspects in mind, because verification of knowledge will lead us towards the proper utilization of knowledge. Verification of knowledge leads us towards the inquiry of separate. And further, I want to quote a great poet of the East, Allama Iqbal. And I will translate it for the audience. He says, Almi ijad mein jo ho sahibi ijad, karta hai har daur mein tawaf uska zamana. Iqbal says that when a person lives in his life, entire life is a research platform for him. If he does something, if he creates something in the entire world, right till this world will be over, he will be remembered like Einstein. He has said it's called MC square. We, everyone on this earth knows Einstein. So research is a very intellectual process. It is not everybody's cup of tea. It is not a soft option. Research needs highly intellectual deep thinking. It needs broader perspective if you want to be a researcher. And research is a very dynamic process. It changes its objectives from time to time, from situation to situation. The research objectives which you will set here will be different from those which you are setting from in another country. So simply, research is that process which changes, which is always in a constant flux. But remember one thing, the slogan of researchers never change. Slogan of researchers is the search for truth. Yeah, from this presentation it is clear that why we have to take under this undertake research, and we have to provide solutions, we have to create new knowledge. So it is clearly reflected. Next one, here I have this divergent opinions on research, because different people have their different opinions. For a philosopher, research may be even a new idea, new theory, but for a scientist it is something different. It is a innovation, discovery. Similarly for intellectuals, it is a new generalization. And for students who are in the process of their PhD or who are busy with their dissertation, research may be their point for to make their career. And in especially in our India, our institutions have now become academic cafeterias, where our degrees, especially MPhil, PhDs or degrees, are sold at handsome cost. Even to some professionals in the area of research, this research has become a source of livelihood. We are submitting a number of research projects, not for the sake of knowledge, but for the sake to earn the money. Next one. Yeah. Research originates with a question. When you doubt something, it becomes a problem. So doubting or questioning on something, it becomes the beginning point for a research. All progress is born of research. One of the biggest feature of the research is that it is a R&D concept. Now we will come to the types of research. From the general point of view, research is of three types. Fundamental research, it is a very tough research where you are creating entirely new knowledge, new theories. It is very easy to say E is equal to MC square, but you can ask Einstein how much intellectual effort he may have put to develop E is equal to MC square. This is an example of fundamental research. Next one, applied research. Applied research, it is whatever research is in we are doing in the entire world, much research goes in the field of applied research. When you have to find the solutions to the immediate problems which a person or a society or an organization is facing. Next one. Yeah, action research. Usually action research is a what research which you are doing by involving your common sense. Just in the first sessions I told that computer was having some problem. So we can use our common sense in order to solve a number of problems. That research becomes a common sense research. Yeah. Now the question is, knowledge is the fountain of research. Yes, research process revolves around the knowledge, because knowledge is power, and power means control over a situation. Your knowledge revolves around This research revolves around the knowledge, and knowledge is power. Those countries which have rich sources of knowledge, they are controlling the entire world. It is not because of this that we have having a great population. No, you can control the situation only when you are having a knowledge. I will quote a simple example. If you are going to operate an ATM machine and you know each and everything, but you don't have the knowledge of PIN, you cannot control that machine because you are lacking the knowledge. So proper knowledge is very much necessary, and creation, generation, discovery, all these are the goals of the knowledge. And it has been clearly reflected by the National Knowledge Commission that if India intends to be a developed country, then it has to develop its all knowledge resources. Yeah, how to research? We know it that. Yeah, and we have to locate the research paper, we have to read the abstract, and so on. Yes, research is a highly academic activity. And other than an advanced creative activity, research is now considered as the highest level of education in any education system, and usually it starts from the master's level because you have a dissertation part in the master's, and MPhil PhD is strictly the research, so it acts as the highest level in any education system, especially in India. It is because of research we can keep our knowledge alive. Research is the backbone for sustaining in the global society in the contemporary era, and I believe that research is universal as well as global heritage, because research can make human being sustainable in the contemporary era when he is having challenges and challenges 24 hours around his life. Thank you, sir. Over to sir.